Judy, welcome to my channel, and today I am going to be doing a whole load of stuff with W7 Cosmetics. It's a kind of a mixture of things that we've got going on here. There's a bit of a haul. Most of this stuff came from amazon.co.uk. There's a bit of a testing things out. I have to confess and say that there is not a huge amount of first impressions, because I'm finding that one of the things I need to do if I'm going to do a reasonable job is I need to practice and play with a product before I bring it to the video. Today I've done you two looks. I've done a fairly quick natural look, and then I've done this more full evening occasional type look for you, and I hope you like it. I'm absolutely gobsmacked with this necklace. I made this necklace a while ago, and when I made it, it was a choker. Seriously. Can you see? And now, it's not a choker. Ah, so yes, the weight loss is going well. If you'd like to know more about the weight loss, I will link my diabetic journey videos in the description bar, and you can go and have a look at them. So, what have we got to show for you today? Let me just get my price list up on the screen so that I can work through these. And I'm just going to put my glasses on so that I can actually see prices. Oh, hello world, there you are. Right, so I am working with the W7 Porefection Pore Minimizer. This is £3.50 and was from Amazon. And then I have the Angel Balm Line Eraser, which was $2.99. And then I got the Power All Day Wear Eyeshadow Primer for £2. And then I bought two Featherlight foundations. I've got one in Sand Beige and one in Buff. The Sand Beige set me back £3.15 and the Buff was £2.60. This is the thing about the Amazon marketplace, is that you will find that prices vary a huge amount. It's same product from a different reseller will look at a different price. So my advice is shop around, but I will link the places that I bought these from because I think their service has been pretty good. Then we have the Light Diffusing Concealer Pen, and I will give you my honest opinion of that later on. And then we have the Brow Parlour Complete Eyeshadow Grooming Kit. And this is just a really great kit that I've found is good. The nice thing about it is that it has a little mirror inside. So it's a great one to bundle up and take on the go. Because the rest of this stuff doesn't have any mirrors with it. Yep. Then I've got the Naughty 9 shades of eyeshadow colour, which I just, the pigmentation in this is brilliant, as is In the City. This is 6 nudes. This is kind of, this looks to me as though it's a dupe of the Naked Basics eyeshadow palette. And the Naughty Nights was £2.88 and the In the City was £2.18. Then we have the King Cole Eyeliner Pencil, which is in Blackest Black, and it's £1.46. Then I've got an eyeliner pen. Where's it gone? There we go. This is the eyeliner pen, and it's got a nice felt tip on it, so you get a lot of control out of it, which for those of us who are not good at doing liquid eyeliner is a blessing. And it was £2.33. Then we move on to contour, and I've got the Shape Your Face Contour Kit, which came with a little brush. There we go. Now, I don't use the brush in the video, but that's just because I forgot about it. But it's actually a really quite nice, soft little brush. And then to help with a little bit of contour, we've got the Hollywood Bronze and Glow. Oh, hang on, the Shape Your Face was £6.23, and the Hollywood Bronze and Glow Kit was £2.44. Next, I've got the Glow Commotion Shimmer Highlight Eyeshadow, and it came with a fan brush. It's not a Real Techniques fan brush, but it's the same purple. It was purple. And that was £3.99 for both the brush and the highlighter, and then I've got the Honolulu bronzer. This looks vaguely familiar in terms of packaging, and again it comes with a little brush, and that was £2.50. Then next to that I got the Honeycomb blusher, which has got some beautiful colours inside it. Let me see if I can get that out so that you can see. And it was a nice cheap £1.54. Really, you can't do much better than that, really. And then I've got the lip twister. This is a twisting lip liner, so you don't need to have a pencil sharpener with you. And that was £1.95. Then I've got the Skinny Lipping Matte Liquid Lipstick, and that was £3.01. This is Danny Boy, and I wear that in the first part of the video. And then I got their waterproof mascara. I really like a waterproof mascara. This is the Absolutely Waterproof, and it was £2.99. Then I got a Banana Dreams face powder. This is a bit like the Ben Nye loose face powder, and it came with a 10 mil, this is 18 mil, a 10 mil fixer setting spray for, has it gone, £3.95. Those two together for £3.95, and you get 20 grams of powder in this, so an awful lot, a lot of bang for your buck. So then because I used up all of the fixer spray, I had to order another thing of fixer spray. This is the Matte Fixer face spray. You get 18 mils on this one, and it set me back £2.06. Right, and then finally, this was not from Amazon. I bought this when I happened to be in B&M the other day. And this is the Lip Explosion Lip Color Palette. You get 12 lip colors, and it was £3.99. So what I'll say for, just to give you a general overview, and then we'll get into the depths of how the product performed on my face and the looks that I've created with it. The value for money is incredible. For £69 to have got myself all of this entire face of makeup, and it will last me for ages. The pigmentation is good. The quality is great. There are a couple of ingredients that I'm not too happy about, you know, talc in some of the eyeshadows and the various other bits and pieces, but yeah, they do have a tendency to use talc a bit, but you know, it's cheap, so that's why they can get away with it. That's why they use talc. Personally, when I'm making my own products, I don't use talc. I'll use a starch that is not a talc-based starch, oak silk or arrowroot or corn powder or something that is different, but these people are using talc. So anyway, let's get on to the video, and I hope you enjoy it. Right, so let's get started. I'm going to start with the Pore Minimizer Primer, which I think is supposed to be a dupe of the Benefit Professional. It looks very similar. It's a slightly whipped texture, so it actually feels softer and sleeker than the Professional. It goes on smoothly, but it does feel a little thinner. After that, because I'm having problems with issues with my pores around my nose, etc., and I probably need to do a nose thingy strip for my nose at some point, I'm going to follow that up with this. This is the W7 Angel Balm Line Eraser, and I think that this is also another dupe of another Benefit product. Some of you may remember it. I think it's a little bit less hyped now than it used to be. Dr. Feel Good was what it was, and it's a balm. Oops, sorry about that, guys. It comes with a sponge, but I don't use the sponge. I find the sponge, it goes flaky and horrible and disgusting very quickly. So I just leave it in there to keep the balm from forming the skin. And then I use my fingers, because the warmth of my fingers warms the balm through and gets it to a point where it's nice and malleable on my skin. So rub my finger in, and then I just go where I think I've got problems with my pores. So on my cheeks here, down my nose a bit. And you can see it's quite beeswaxy. I don't think it actually has beeswax in it. No beeswax. But it's got various other things. There's some palm oil in there. Slightly worrying is it's got aluminium starch in it, but actually it's not too bad. It's got some, is that sericite mica? No. Well, I don't know. There's lots of interesting things in it. Some of them, you know, most of it's unpronounceable, but if you go and look them up, you can find out what they are. So yeah, just add to where I think I've got problems with my pores. And I just find the warmth of my finger is enough to really get it in and get it warming up my face a bit. Right. So that's the Angel Balm. I really like this one. This one's not too bad. Right. So to start with, for the lighter look, because I've got two different foundations. Let me just sort that mirror out. Okay. I thought what I would do is go in with, I've got the W7 Featherlight foundation, and I actually have it in two shades. I have it in buff and sand beige, and if I remember correctly, I just it says shake before use, so I'm shaking. The sand beige is the darker of the two, and it's the one that's actually closest to my skin color, so that's the one I'm going to go in with. I have a dampened Real Techniques, I think they call it the complexion sponge. And I'm just going to go in and put a few dots onto the big part of that and just start tapping that in. This is a very light, when they say featherweight, they're not joking, but it is buildable. But it just gives a really nice light touch to the foundation. I'll do one half of my face so that you can see what the coverage is like. That's a few more drops on there. I'm just going to do half of my forehead. I'm not being stingy with this. So that's my face with the lightweight foundation on, and that's without. And you can see it's a very, very natural look. Okay, so now because I'm trying to keep this a fairly lightweight look today, what I'm going to do for concealer is I'm just going to go in with that same foundation, the Featherlight foundation, but this is in the lighter colour, this is in the buff. So I'm just going to put a few drops on, one or two, and we'll go underneath that eye area. Now that I've distributed it with the sponge, I'm just going to go in with my finger and tap that in. Because it is so light, it spreads so easily. And then I'm just going to tap off the excess with my complexion sponge. Again, just pouncing motions, no swiping. We don't want to lift the foundation off the face. Although I have to say I've put too much on this side. So the little pointy bit of the sponge really allows you to get into those nooks and crannies. And there we go. Right, for the first look, I'm going to use the Brow Parlour Kit. And this is a great little kit. It comes with a wax, two powders, and a highlighter, plus a little tweezer and a tiny, tiny, tiny little brush. So, actually the brush isn't too bad. I mean, it's small, but it does the job. So, first things first, just brush those brows into place. And then I'm just going to go in with, I've got my Real Techniques eyebrow brush here. And we're just going to go in, I'm going to go in with a combination of the two colours. I'm going to start with the lighter colour, which is really quite a lighter brown than you think it's going to be. It looks reasonably dark inside the palette, but you'll see when it goes on. It goes on quite almost red. This would suit someone with red tinges in their hair. But I find that with most brow products, I can make them work. I have the right coloured eyebrows. I see lots of people who dye their eyebrows to match their hair, and I think at my age that's probably not appropriate. It just doesn't seem to work, and it sets off, changes the whole colour and structure of my face, and everything else has to change then. Right, so that's the lighter colour. Now I'm just going to go in with that darker colour and just brush that through the thicker part of my brow. And then I'm going to go back with the little brush that came with the thing and brush that powder through just a little, because we're trying to keep this a natural look. And then I'm just going to go in with a little bit of the wax and just set some of that powder. I don't want to do too much here. And then that is all I'm going to do with the brows right now. So then I'm going to do my usual trick with my Kohl pen. I have here the W7 King Kohl eyeliner pencil, and this is in blackest black, and I'm just going to put a little bit, like I normally do, from the corner to between a third and half of my eye, not too much. What I want to do is just thicken up my eyebrows a little, sorry, not my eyebrows, my eyelashes a little, make them look as though there's more of them. And then I'm just going to go in, I've got the, which brush will I use? I'm going to use the, this is the Real Techniques Accent Brush. I'm just going to smudge that out a little bit. Right, so then next I'm going to go in with the In the City Eye Colour Palette. This is 6 colours of nudes, and I'm going to go in with a Real Techniques Deluxe Crease Brush, and I'm going to go in with that lightest colour on the edge there and just use it kind of as an eyeshadow primer. And then I'm going to go in with, I think, this colour here as a nice transition. I wonder if these have names. Yes, they do. The one I'm going in with, the first one I used was Wigwam, and this one that I'm going in with now is called Touch. And I'm going to put a touch of it on my upper crease, remembering that I have hooded eyes, so any shadow that goes onto my eyelids when I'm relaxed and looking straight ahead is virtually going to disappear. So okay, now I'm going to go in with my base shadow brush, and I'm going to go into the next colour along with from that one, which is called Autumn. It's a slightly darker, ever so slightly greener grey tone, and I'm just going to go in lower to my crease line to just darken up that colour on the corner there. And then I'm going to go back in with the fluffier of that brush. This is my base shadow brush. And just blend that together. Now I'm going to go in with, this is the detailer brush. And I'm going to go in with that same autumn colour. and just run that into the eyeliner on my lower lid, my lash. And then I'm going to go in with the darkest colour, which is called Andrea, and take that into the outer V, and no more than a third of the way across, slightly up into the crease, because again, remember, when I am relaxed and looking straight ahead, all colour on my lid disappears. I want to put colour on my lid so that when I'm looking surprised, it doesn't look silly. But I need to remember that a bit of that colour needs to go up somewhere where people can see it, or otherwise I look two-tone. Now, I really like these shadows, they blend out nicely. So I'm just going to blend that in a bit more into the crease there. And then just to balance that, take a little bit more on the detailer brush and literally just touch the corner of my eye there. See, I've got one eye that's less hooded than another, so I just need to make sure that they are looking relatively balanced. So, right, what am I going to do? So next thing I'm going to, we'll put on mascara now because I can do that. And this is the absolutely waterproof mascara. And I'm really quite enjoying it. I do need a waterproof mascara as my eyes do have a tendency to run. If I'm out particularly in a cold breeze, or I'm finding that hay fever is having more of an impact on me than it used to. And that's all I'm going to do for the eyes for the moment. So then we are going to go to bronzer. Now I have here, this is the Hollywood Bronze and Glow kit, and some of you may recognize it as looking a little bit like a certain other kit out there. I don't have that certain other kit, and I'm sure it's lovely, but I can't afford it, so here we go. I'm going to keep it again fairly light today, so we're just going to go in with a little bit of bronzer to just kind of carve out the cheeks a bit. And I want to go, if I imagine a line running from the top of my temple down through the corner of my eye in a straight line, I want to keep my bronzer in that point. I want to keep it quite high as well, because that will just lift my face up a bit. So a little bit in the temple, under the jawline, but not too much, because this is supposed to be a calm daytime look. Now, I only have one blusher, so I'm going to use it. It's the Honeycomb blusher, and it comes in a little box like this. And again, the packaging may seem a little familiar. Have we seen this somewhere else? It has a little brush with it, which is not a bad little brush. I'll show you something later. And then this is a blusher. This one's a very warm toned blusher, which I find is absolutely great for a daytime look. So I'm going to go in with my buffing brush, because it's the softest of the Real Techniques brushes I've had. Again, remembering that I have this line running down my face here, we're just going to go in and hit the top of that bronzer. There we go. Just a little hint of blush there. Warms up the face a little bit, and then with a little bit of what I've got left over on the brush, again, just hit the temples. Again, provides a little bit of warmth. Then I'm going to go back to the Hollywood Bronze and Glow kit, and this time I'm going to go in with, this one is the pointed foundation brush, which I would never use for foundation, but I really quite like it because it's got a nice slender top. So I'm going to go into the highlighter here. This is a really nice subtle highlighter, and I'm just going to hit the top of the cheek. And then for lip, I have the Lip Twister in Nude. How original is that? And this I think is really good because it screws up and down, so you don't have to have a pencil sharpener with you. And then I'm going to use the matte liquid lipstick, which is called Skinny Lipping, and it is in the shade Danny Boy, if I remember correctly. Yes, Danny Boy. And again, do you think W7 are dropping hints to certain manufacturers about packaging? A nice brown nude. And that is our natural quick daytime look, which took nearly 13 minutes. So not too bad. Right, okay, now I've taken off that first look and I have reprimed with the Porfection and the eye balm over the pores, and I've put just a little bit of extra up here and a little bit down the chin here because this is going to be a slightly more made up look, if you like. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I have the Got the Eye Power All Day Wear eyeshadow base primer in Wicked. So I'm just going to place little tiny dots. This has got a slight shimmer in it. You can see that there's an ever so slight shift in it, but it pretty much disappears once it's pressed into your eyelid, and it does provide a nice grippy look, grippy base. The only tiniest amount. Notice I'm not taking it all the way up to my brow. Right, so this time, the foundation I'm going to use is the Photoshoot 16 Hour Budge Proof Foundation. And I'm using it in the shade Buff. So this is light, slightly lighter than the Sand Beige. And it's probably a little bit too light for me. I probably do need to get the... So W7, a pump top would be nice, but I'm just going to pour a little bit out onto my sponge here. And just dot that around. I'll do half my face again so that you can see what the coverage is like with one layer. Okay, so there's one side of my face with the foundation on and the other side without. You can see the coverage is slightly better than the previous foundation, than the Featherweight. But again, both are buildable. So I'm just going to finish doing the other side of my face. And there we go. Now, I think the Photo Finish foundation takes a little bit more effort to blend out and get an even tone across your face, but then it is a heavier base, so that's not surprising. And you know, if you're using this for an evening look, then you might want to just be spending a little bit more time making sure your makeup. So this time I'm using the Light Diffusing Concealer. And I think this is kind of a little bit like the Touche Eclat, although I've never tried the Touche Eclat. I've had the L'Oreal one that looks like this. So this one is a bit different from the L'Oreal. It says it's got some light diffusing bits in it. And it certainly, I don't know if you can see, but it certainly has texture in it. Whether or not that texture actually helps or makes things worse for me, I'm not entirely convinced. It seems to work well down the bridge of my nose. It's okay up there and it's okay on my chin, but I'm really not convinced about how it works under my eyes. But in the interests of YouTube, we'll pat it in and see if we can make it work. And the other times I've tried this, I think I've managed to make it work once, which doesn't bode well for a product. But it means that I'm trying to do things with products without necessarily having the skills behind me to make a difficult product work. I'm just going to go in with my complexion sponge again and just kind of soften all of those edges. Okay, there, quite happy with that. It's okay, it's a lot of work, and therefore on a daily basis I probably wouldn't be using it, because who has time? Particularly if you remember that a lot of the stuff that I put on, I have a tendency to put on in the car. So, right, next is... No, I've got my brow parlour. Yes, of course. I'm going to go back in with the brow parlour, which has got various little bits and pieces in it. And again, just start by brushing my brows into place. And I'm going to take the Real Techniques brow brush. This is the brow brush. And I'm just going to, because I'm doing a darker look now, a less natural look, I'm just going to go in with that dark shade. And this time I'm not going to soften them up, because I'm trying to go for a slightly more full look. I'm just going to take that wax. And I'm just going to put some of it into the brow to just set that powder in place. Quite a thick wax, you can actually see it going onto my eyebrows. And then once I've put some wax on, I will run the brush, the spoolie brush, through once more to just disperse the wax out a bit so that my eyebrows aren't glued to my head. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a clean brush. This is my Bobbi Brown double-ended brush. And I'm just going to go into that white colour that's on the palette there. And I'm just going to go in under the brow to just tidy up that edge a little. The next step is the one that I always do. I know I'm going to be doing a more full eyeliner look, but I still quite like to start with a little bit of pencil on my lower lashes, because it just makes them look a little bit fuller as I work through, and it blends out really nicely while I'm applying the shadow. So I'm just going to tap the corners with that eyebrow pencil. Shadow. I'm going to go in with, to start off with, I'm going to go in with that same palette that I did before, the In the City palette, because it's got some really nice transition colours in it. So I'm going to take my fluffiest of my Real Technique brushes, if I can find where I've put, there it is, and I'm going to go in with the colour Touch again as my transition colour. I'm just going to put a slight hint of that into the upper crease, just to give me a good base to start with. And then I'm going to blend that out using the same brush with Wigwam, the bright light colour on the end here. that will just blend the whole lot together to give me a seamless base to start with. So I've got eyeshadow primer, I've got that highlighter on my brow bone, and now I've got Touch and Wigwam on my lid to set all of those creams in the face. In the City goes away, and I have another W7 palette here. This is the Naughty 9, Naughty Shades of Eye Colour in Bangkok Nights. And it has a couple of matte purples, but mostly shimmer shades. So I'm just going to go in with a Real Techniques base shadow brush, and I'm going to go in with this purple here up the top. We don't have colors, individual color names for the powders, so this is a nice, what I would refer to as a transition purple, and I'm just going to take that into my crease. And you see now that I've put that brown on underneath and the Touch and the Wigwam, this purple will just blend out beautifully. And I'm only just doing the lightest of touches. These shadows are quite pigmented, but they do have a fair amount of fallout. I'm guessing that's because they're made with talc. Yes, they have no, they've got paraffin in them, but they don't have, and they've got a synthetic wax. But I would be putting Sericite mica with a bit of canava wax coated, treated with a bit of canava wax treated into it, so that it gives it a slightly silkier feel. I'll probably also be including a oat silk rather than talc, because talc is not supposed to be very good for you anymore. Right, so there we go. We've got that soft purple running through. And now I'm just going to go in with the same brush, and I'm going to go in with, I think, this darker purple in the middle here. I'll just go in gently because I really don't want to, I want this to blend. So thin layers will work better. Now, one of the things that you'll notice on a lot of YouTubers when they're doing lessons on makeup tutorials is they talk about doing this windscreen wiper motion. Well, if I do a windscreen wiper motion, can you see how much my lid moves around? Which means that I can't control where the colour's going. So I find actually if I just do, I'm lifting it up each time I finish a stripe. I'm just going in with a delicate touch, and that just allows me to control where the colour is going. Same thing on this side. Little kind of half moon circles. You can see where my eyelid wrinkles up. Maybe go back the other way. But this whole windscreen wiper motion doesn't get me the coverage that I want. Doesn't get me the blending that I want. So I kind of have a tendency to go in circles rather than wash a wipe. I'm happy with that now. Now I think what I'm going to do is I want to take some of that colour in under the eye. So I'm going to go in with the detailer brush into that same purple, and we're just going to run, smudge that purple out under the eye. And I find with the detailer brush I always get a more dense colour. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take that detailer brush and go back in and just draw a little line into that upper crease. Now what I'm doing is I'm actually painting. If I put my finger there, I can feel my brow bone where my socket starts. So I'm treating that as my crease line. I don't want to put it into the socket because it will just disappear. I want to put it on the actual edge of that bone, so that again, when I close my lid, can you see there's that little tiny line there, and I will blend it out. But that just gives me the idea of where to put that color so that it doesn't disappear when I close my eyes. And again, I'm feeling up here and I can feel the edge of my socket. I'll tidy up this bit afterwards. So again, detail a brush on the other side. And now I'm going to go back in with my base shadow brush. This has got a bit of that lighter purple on it, and I'm just going to blend that up. Keep checking back, keep looking straight ahead, and make sure that it's blending nicely so that when your eyes are open, you don't look too stern. These shadows blend really nicely. They're not to be sneezed at. Right, so now just for a little bit of fun, I'm going to go in with this dark purple here on the edge, and we're just going to darken up that outer V and down into the lower lash. And again, just give it a bit of a blend. Okay. Now I've got a little bit of fun going on here. Right, I'm just going to take a tiny amount of setting spray on my brush. I have to do it this other way around because I'm right-handed. And I've got a bit of a glimmer shade going on here in the middle. So I'm just going to take that brush into the glimmer shade. And I'm just going to pack that onto the middle of my eye. And I'm going to take a brush and just blend that out. And look at how much that's just changed the whole look. So I want to use that brush again, so I'm just going to take a wipe and clean it off a bit. And this time I'm going to go in with the pink in the top corner here, which again is a shimmer, and I'm just going to take that into my inner corner. Now, because I have small eyes, one of the things I can get away with is actually doing quite a lot of shimmer in the corner, because it makes my eyes look further apart. There's got to be some advantage to having shimmer. So there we go. So now the next step is we're going to go back in with mascara. This is the same mascara that I used before. It's the Waterproof from W7. And we're going to do one layer on the top. Let that dry, come back in a bit, and do more. I want to do a little bit of liquid liner, and I'm going to do that now before I put on my second layer. So I have here the Extra Fine Super Precision Eyeliner Pen, black waterproof. I can't do a wing and I can't carry one off, so I'm not going to try. But what I can do is I can lay the pen down against my eyelid and draw a line. I'm just going to take some down into the lower lash line and just intensify that as well. Again, no more than halfway across. It will just make my eyes look droopy and small. Okay, so while that mascara and eyeliner is drying, I'm going to do cheeks. And I have the Honolulu bronzer. You might recognize the packaging, it's somewhat familiar. It actually has a cute little brush in it that does quite a good job. So I'm going to use the brush that comes with it, and I'm going to do a quite high bronze line. And again, as I did in the first half here, I'm imagining a line that's running down from the middle of my temple, down through the corner of my eye to my chin, and I'm not bringing my bronzer any sooner than that. Going quite high on the cheekbone, and that's getting me a good placement. Up through the hairline to the brow. Tiniest of tops. This stuff goes a long way, and if you put too much on, it looks orange. And yeah, don't want to look orange. So now I'm just going to take a little bit down the edge of my cheek there and onto my jawline. I'm going to warm up my face nicely. And then I'm going to take a bigger, fluffier brush and blend that out. I'm not going to try and blend it out with that little brush because it just won't work. So let's start with the cheekbones. I'm going to go back over that with a little bit of contour. The bronzer is just to warm up the face. The contour will actually sculpt out my cheeks. And then I will go over the top of with a bit of blusher. So it'll all soften up in a bit. Okay, I have here now the Shape Your Face Contour Kit, which has two shades of contour. There's a darker grey, a browner brown, and then a highlight. The highlight's not very highlighty, it's quite understated actually. So I'm going to go back in with that big fluffy brush. For those of you who've seen some of my past videos, this is a brush by Thin Lizzy, and it comes with their contour kit and their 6-in-1 contour kit, and I think it's a brilliant brush. But you have to order it from Australia. So we have the darker brown, and again just going in underneath that contour and just adding a bit of extra shadow underneath that bronze. Don't want to add too much. And again, darken up the jaw a bit. Don't want to do too much contour because it'll make you look dirty. I'm going in with the medium brown here, just again warming up that forehead a bit. And then I'm going to go in with that brown. I'm just going to fan the brush out in my hands. And we're just going to take a little bit on the edge of the nose. And that's probably a little too much. So we'll just take another fluffy brush and soften it out a bit, because otherwise because I've got an orange nose. Okay, happy with that. Right, now we're going to go back to the blusher that I used before, because it's the only blusher that I've got. This is the Queen Honey blusher. But because I'm now talking a slightly darker color for the nighttime, or a slightly more fixed look, I'm going to avoid this brown color in the middle of the box and just take the color from the corner so that I get a lighter, peachier color. And again, we're just going to take that just over the bronzer. The bronzer was here. Take the blush a little bit higher, and I'm not going to do the apples of my cheeks. This is a trick that I learned from Wayne Goss, and I'm finding that it's working because it keeps this center of my face all light. It's actually helping with me feeling as though I'm not looking older. Now I can go back in with a bit more of that mascara and flesh out those lashes. I don't do false lashes, but I'm more than happy to coat my
lashes up with lots of mascara. Oh, try not to poke yourself in the eye. And I'm going to just do those bottom lashes. Highlighter. So I have here the Glow Commotion highlighter, and they say that this is a shimmer highlighter eyeshadow. I wouldn't use this as an eyeshadow. It would make me look ancient very, very quickly. But it is quite a fine milled highlighter, although it's difficult to get into. It's quite a nicely filmed, quite a nice, finely milled highlighter. And it came with, this is not Real Techniques, people. This is another brush, but it came with the brush. So I quite like using it with the brush. And we're just going to take a bit of that on there, and we're going to go right up the top here. Again, line through the from the middle of the temple, down through the corner of the eye, to the bottom of the cheek, and we're just going to take it into that top level there. And boom! Can you see that? Oh my goodness. Right, and on the other side, I'm going to take a tip on the nose, Cupid's bow, chin, across the temple, to just give a gentle, light diffusing look. What we want to do is we want to distract the face, the eye away from all of these lovely little wrinkles. Okay, now before I do my lipstick, I'm just going to go in and I'm going to do some setting of the various things. This is the Banana Dreams powder, and it's a loose powder, but I'm only going to do the powder in the places that I really want it to be powdered. So I'm not going to, I don't want to change that highlighter. I just want to get in and just gently powder up. So I don't want it to crease under my eyes or around my nose. This would be the places where one might carry oil, if one still had oil in one's skin. Underneath the nose, do a bit down the cheeks, but I don't want to cover up that highlighter. And then just to tidy that up, I'm going to go in. I have two of these Thin Lizzy fluffy brushes, and they're so soft, they're lovely. So I keep one for light and one for dark. So I'm just going to go in with that and kind of dust off any excess. Lipstick. I'm going to go back in with that nude twist lip twister pencil and just outline my lips. And then outline my upper lip. And another trick I learned from Wayne Goss. Is to draw a line between the two peaks on your lips. And it will make your lips look a little plumper without looking overdrawn. Oh, and then for final, I have, oh, sorry about that, people. I have the Lip Explosion Lip Color Palette. And this one wasn't from Amazon. This I bought from B&M. Comes with 12 colors, and six of them I would say are bordering on matte, and then six of them are quite glossy and metallic. These are not the most long-staying lipsticks. But the colours are kind of pretty. They're kind of muted autumnal colours. And it came with a double-ended lip brush, which normally I throw out these brushes, but because it's quite mucky, you can see that I've tried it out and I've dug into them a bit. I'm finding if I keep this lip brush with them, then I've got a greater chance of it not mucking up the rest of my makeup brush. So I think because I'm going for a slightly more evening look here, I'm going to go in with this colour here, which is Kate Cross. It's called Legs 11. It's a kind of a plummy metallic colour. And then finally, because this is the one I'm going to stay with now, the look that I'm going to stay with now, I am just going to set all of that. I have here the W7, the Matte Fixer Face Spray. They come in tiny little bottles, but they're quite cheap, so I'm not going to complain. Right, here we go. So, if you enjoyed this look and enjoyed seeing how the makeup works, let's give you a quick summary here. What the things that I liked and what I didn't like. I really quite like the featherweight foundations in the two different colours. I think they work well as for a day look. I'm not quite so impressed with the 16-hour photo shoot foundation. I think it takes a little bit too much to blend. I really quite like the Angel Balm Line Eraser. I just think that smooths things out that wouldn't otherwise get smoothed. The Perfection, I think, is as good as the Benefit Professional at a tiny smidgen of the cost. I like the blendability of all of the eyeshadows. I'm not a huge fan of the eye primer. I don't think it actually does a huge amount for me that the primer itself on its own doesn't do. I love the Locomotion highlighter. I just think that's kind of real bam. But I'm not a fan of the highlighter that's in this at all. It's not really much of a highlighter. I wouldn't really call it a highlighter. I quite like the Bronze and Glow highlighter. The mascara feels nice. The liquid matte lipstick is a little too drying for me. But if I combine the matte liquid lipstick with the Lip Explosion lip colours, then it works really quite nice and it's quite moisturising. The only problem is that the size of this means it's impossible to carry with me on the go to do touch-ups and refreshes, which is a bit annoying. I really like the Kohl eyeliner. I use that a lot, the King Kohl. The liquid liner, the extra fine liquid liner, I don't use that often because I find that it dries out during the application and that's a bit of a pain. I am not a fan of the concealer, the light diffusing concealer. It just doesn't feel as though it conceals anything and it feels as though it accentuates things a little bit too much. I love the box bronzer and the box blushes. I think these are marvellous. I'm going to have a look and see if I can find another one of these in a slightly pinkier tone because that suits my colouring better. But I'm really quite pleased with these, and for the price, I mean, this was £2.60. So, you know, you really can't complain about too much of this. All of the stuff that I've shown you today set me back a total of £69.58. Most of it I bought from Amazon, so I will link where I got everything from. I will do a shout out here to an Amazon seller called Lydia Beauty, who have sold me several items from this collection, and their service is amazing. So it's Lydia Beauty. Definitely go and have a look at them on Amazon, and basically the easiest way to find them is to search on Amazon for W7 products and it will come up and show you. And although Lydia Beauty doesn't do a huge amount of stuff that is available on Prime, their service is amazing. Everything comes well packaged, and I ordered something from them 2 days ago and was told by their system that it would come on the 31st of July, and here we are and it's the 21st. So the fact that it arrived 10 days earlier than I had anticipated was amazing. They also do bundles. They did me the Banana Dreams powder and a different fixer, the non-matte fixer for, what was that? Let's have a look. Where's it gone? I think it was $3.99. Can't see it at the moment. I'm not wearing my glasses. And then they did the, what else did I get from them? I got the fan brush and the Glowcomotion came from them. And then I reordered the mat and the mat fixer. And I ordered the brow parlor kit from them. And their service is amazing. So shout out to Lydia Beauty, brilliant job. So thank you very much for watching this video and sticking with me, and I hope you enjoyed it. And if you would like to see more of my makeup videos, what is it? Basically someone who's having fun with makeup, playing with it and trying new things out. I'm not an expert, I don't know what I'm doing, but I seem to do an okay job and you seem to like it. So thanks very much for watching, and I look forward to talking to you again. Bye!